Why would ferritin rise on a low-carb diet when iron status is stable? Note that in this episode, I focus on copper, but oxidative stress, discussed elsewhere, is an important consideration. Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Philippa Antel, question number two. Some people on a long-term low-carb diet seem to see slowly rising levels of ferritin. Their transferrin saturations are normal, below 35%. So they're not iron overloaded, and they have a CRP less than one and low white blood cells. No obvious infection and inflammation. What do you think could be causing the rising ferritin? Well, they sound copper deficient because copper is needed to mobilize iron out of ferritin. Copper is most abundant in plant foods, except that it's also very rich in liver, and it's pretty decent in a number of shellfish. But, you know, on a low-carb steak and cheese diet, not only are you deficient in copper, but you are also now pushing your zinc levels up, which will lower your copper absorption. Low white blood cells is, first thing I'm gonna look at is copper levels, especially if the neutrophils are low. And that would very easily explain rising ferritin. So I would revise my position if they were in the top half of the serum copper range. But if they're in the bottom half, especially the bottom third, I'm still going to be thinking copper. And if they're below the range for copper, then I'm going to be firmly concluding copper. So that's the first thing that I would look at. Thank you, Philippa, for your question. I'll come back to your other questions after I get to some other people.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. For the remainder of 2020, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.